You two are ichthyologists?
Sure.
Sure.
That's somebody who studies fish.
That's right. Today I'm an ichthyologist.
That's right. So this is a lake sturgeon, one of two native sturgeon found in Wisconsin. This is a juvenile. So this one has been raised in captivity. And so it's about, what we think, about 8 months old. Sturgeons take a long time to mature. The males aren't typically mature until they're about 15 or so, and the females anywhere from 20 to 25 years. So most fish in Wisconsin, not all, but most fish in Wisconsin are covered with scales. This fish, the sturgeon, is also protected, but instead of scales, it has what are called scutes, which are much more elaborate, thicker, stronger bony structures. If you were to grab one of these without a lot of care, you'd actually cut your hand.
So rumor has it this fish has been around since the time of the dinosaur. Is that?
Yeah, well, not this fish or not this exact species.
Not
but,
our little.
But certainly the sturgeon lineage dates back a couple hundred million years. The other thing you notice is how nicely it lays flat. Mm-hmm. So it's designed for being on the bottom. What's really interesting about the mouth, first of all, is that the mouth is oriented downward, so that tells you that the fish is feeding on items off the bottom. And it's actually protrusible, which means that the lips actually, it's a little bit hard to see, but the lips actually kind of come out and they can make kind of a suction and suck things up off the bottom. So you see when I squeeze it, how the mouth sort of sticks out. And they use that then. So if there's a little insect they're trying to eat that's between a crack they can't reach, they will basically suck it out the way a vacuum cleaner might do.
And what's happening here?
So these are what are called barbels. Mm-hmm. They have four of these, and again, they're loaded with taste buds just like our tongue would be. Mm-hmm. And it would be as if we were sticking our tongue out in the water and then dragging it along the bottom to taste what was going on there. The one thing I also want to point out are the gills. So it's not only a breathing organism, but it's also a waste removal organ. Sturgeon and all other freshwater fish are constantly urinating. Constantly, constantly, constantly.
So should we take a look inside?
Sure.
See what we see?
This is what's called the vent. This is where it excretes urine. This is where it excretes feces. Mm-hmm. And this is where, depending on whether it's a male or female, the eggs or the sperm are going to be released. So we'll make an incision forward from that.
A little queasy.
Don't want to.
No, I do.
You got to go through the pelvic girdle there. That's what that's called.
Pelvic girdle. Okay. There we go.
Well, that's just half-digested goo.
is that the scientific term
that's
for
the
it?
Scientific. Well, the other one you can't say.
Yeah.
This large, dark structure going all the way back to the vent is part of the sturgeon intestine. Oh. And so this is where the food that it takes in is digested and the nutrients are absorbed.
It's all connected.
Yep.
You said the stomach was up here, right?
That hardness is the muscular stomach. This is the heart right here.
Oh, yeah.
The sturgeon, because it eats primarily animal matter, either insects or in some cases fish, has a relatively short gut. It's hard to get at, but the other organ would be the brain. Well, for all that work, the brain in a sturgeon is not particularly big or not particularly impressive. It's about this big.
I want to play with the fake mouth. That was really cool the way you pulled it out like that. Ooh, that's really cool.
So they can suck stuff. You know, they create a vacuum here.
I love it.
Yeah, the video of them actually doing that.
Yeah,
The
sturgeon, when they're ready to spawn, the Lake Winnebago system, a large number of fish will then move into the Wolf River upstream of Lake Winnebago and the Fox River upstream of Lake Winnebago. And in some cases, this will involve a migration of at least 100 miles to get to where they're going to spawn. Once they actually start spawning, they really are oblivious to anything else going around them. And they're spawning on these shallow edges, basically right at your feet in a couple of feet of water. And many areas have actually been developed as viewing areas, tourist areas.
Well, I think, that's here in Wisconsin, we have that opportunity because
right.
We have one of the, largest lake sturgeon populations.
Right. We've had very good management and a lot of effort put into protecting and improving our sturgeon populations over the last almost 100 years now.
The sturgeon population is doing well around Lake Winnebago. How is it doing in the Great Lakes wide as a basin?
Yeah, historically there was a very, you know, fairly large Great Lakes population of sturgeon, and, you know, through habitat destruction, overfishing, numbers really got down very low. Now it's very small. You know, with a fish that lives 100 years, any restoration is going to take a lot of time.